Hello, I am Dr. Zeba from New Delhi, India, and today I am going to present my work entitled Lead Substitution in Europium Bismuth Sulfur Fluoride EU3Bi2S4F4, a superconductor to insulator transition. Superconductivity in bismuth sulfide-based compounds was first of all investigated in the year 2012 in the compound Bi4O4S3 by Misoguchi et al. And later by the same group in fluorine-substituted LaOFBIS2. Both these compounds are layer tetragonal. Both these compounds contain layer tetragonal structures in which the conducting BIS2 layer alternates with the blocking layer. The conducting BIS2 layers, they form square pyramid with rock salt type arrangement, and the blocking layer, they have fluoride type of structure. An important class of compounds in the BIS2 based compounds are europium containing BIS2 superconductors. The first compound is EUF-BIS2, and if we add 1 mole of EUF2 in 2 unit cells of EUF-BIS2, we get another layered tetragonal structure with a stoichiometric formula of EU3Bi2S4F4, and both of these compounds become important because both of these are intrinsic superconductors with a TC of 0.3 Kelvin and 1.5 Kelvin respectively. So in the present system, we have tried to investigate the effect of alio-valent lead substitution at bismuth sites for the first time in EU3Bi2S4F4 superconductor. And this has been characterized by powder X-ray diffraction and energy dispersive analysis by X-ray using electron microscopy. And later we have performed resistivity and magnetization studies. The reaction methodology used was solid state sealed tube quartz method. And in the first step, we have synthesized the precursors bismuth sulfide and europium sulfide. And after that, in the second step, we have mixed these precursors with the remaining reactants with our europium fluoride, lead powder, and the bismuth powder. All these reactants are mixed ground well and compacted into a pellet of circular form. And these circular pellets are vacuum sealed in quartz tube, which are then baked at 850 degrees centigrade for 30 hours. This is the powder X-ray diffraction pattern of lead-doped EU3BIS2S4F4 samples, and we can see here clearly that all the reflections could be very well indexed to the tetragonal unit cell with space group of I4 by mmm, and a very small impurity peak corresponding to PB2BI2S6 was also detected, which was less than 5% in all the samples. This is the variation of lattice parameter and hence the lattice volume, which is found to shrink gradually by lead substitution, which suggests that there has been successfully lead doping in the system. We have carried out SEM ADAX for the compositional analysis of all the compounds to determine the exact stoichiometry, and the calculated molar bismuth to lead ratio in all the samples was very close to the nominal value within the accuracy measurement. This is the resistivity plot for X is equals to 0.25 doped sample within the temperature range 300 to 50 Kelvin. And we see that the normal state resistivity corresponds to a semi-metal, and which increases drastically below a temperature of 50 Kelvin. The DC magnetization studies at 50 oersted for all the samples were carried out in zero field mode condition. And for X is equals to 0.25, we see that the sample is paramagnetic with an ordered paramagnetic moment value close to 6.7 Bohr magneton per europium atom per formula unit. And in the inset, we have tried to show the antiferromagnetic ordering corresponding to europium 2 plus spins at 2.3 Kelvin. And all the remaining samples with higher lead content also show the paramagnetic behavior with the magnetic moment varying from plus minus 0.2 to 0.5 Bohr magneton. Hence, I conclude my work with following points: that lead doping in EU3Bi2S4F4 has been successfully carried out, which has been demonstrated by a shrinkage of the unit cell volume, as well as it has been confirmed by SEM EDAX, and the magnetic measurement suggests the presence of mixed valence of europium. and lead doping as small as 12.5% at bismuth sites, it could suppress superconductivity, and a superconductor to insulator transition has been observed. Thank you.